Tom Brady threw his 600 touchdown pass.
I hate that, man.
First time that anybody's ever done it in NFL history. He has a sizable gap on everybody else.
The greatest.
And get this. Tom Brady has 7 Super Bowl rings. He lost to Eli twice. Then he lost to Philly.
Fold.
Tom Brady has been to the Super Bowl 10 times.
Yeah. Donovan McNabb.
Yeah, he beat McNabb.
Tom Brady has been to the Super Bowl 10 times out of 22 years in his career.
Say that one to 10 out of 22.
Tom Brady has been to the Super Bowl 10 times out of the 22 years he's played in the NFL. And out of those 22 seasons, one season he got a torn ACL. His rookie season he didn't play. Tom Brady, by the numbers, has a 45% chance to make the Super Bowl based on his numbers, how many times he's made it versus how long he's played in the NFL. Steph Curry's 3-point percentage is 43%. Tom Brady has a better chance of making the Super Bowl than Curry does.
I would like to know the numbers of him just going to the AFC Championship, because that's probably at like 17 or 18 times.
There's been years where he lost in the AFC Championship game against Denver that one year too.
This topic is just gas up Tom Brady. Talk about Tom Brady.
I love it.
We spoke about this. Tom Brady
is first in passing yards, first in touchdowns. This season, 2,275 yards, 21 touchdowns to 3 interceptions, second in QBR. And the 600 touchdown pass was caught by Mike Evans. He gave it to a fan. The fan gave it back because he said, "I can't say no to Tom Brady." And Tom Brady gave him 2 signed Brady jerseys, a helmet, a signed Mike Evans jersey, and cleats. 2 season tickets for 2 years, $1,000 credit to the Buck store. And he gave him a Bitcoin, which is worth $66,000.
I needed 30K cash.
Well, that's 66K right there.
Well, yeah, that part.
$66,000.
One Bitcoin in many years is going to be worth more.
I needed the Bitcoins and the 30K. I don't care about none of that other stuff. I don't care about the season tickets.
Well, think about it like this. The season tickets, you could sell those for bread.
Let's say he doesn't go to a single game. He could sell every single one of those. That's a few G's right there over 2 seasons. In-store merchandise. Jersey.
I don't care about no damn.
The jersey. The jersey from Brady, the helmet from Brady. That's a few K right there.
Tough.
So he definitely made out, but at the same time, he folded by giving it away right away. If he holds it till the end of the game, that list would have been even more egregious.
They went to him right after.
Which was real. And listen, the guy who gave the ball back deserves endless respect, but at the same time,
you know, I'm going to be honest, I think it actually went better for the guy that he gave it back.
Probably never got
If he held it, he would have been looked down upon, and
might
have not given him that much.
Everyone should look at this dude and just think he's a genuine, real dude.
But he has to make it out the stadium with the ball too.
But they said the ball was valued at a minimum $500K.
I'm gonna be honest though, like if you're in that
Michael
stadium,
Jordan draws is a million.
Such a random thing to throw that's out crazy. There, but that's funny.
No
as
way.
But if you're in that stadium,
I'm gonna show you after.
If you're in that stadium, you see a guy walking with the 600 touchdown ball.
You're going to mama.
You're not trying to get it.
I'm telling y'all, we need to put that.
So funny you say that, because Barry Bonds, when they hit his home run to break Hank Aaron, the guy got it. They escorted him out of the stadium, like security and everything, because they knew exactly.
That's smart.
If it was us four there, if we seen him, we got to do it to him.
But he's.
I would have done the same thing. I would have said, I can't say no to Tom Brady.
Yeah, no.
And I'd go over there, I'd meet Tom Brady.
I would never said no to Zach Wilson. First TD, you'd be like, I can't say no to Zach Wilson. You just gave that right to him. I was like, come on.
I just say I want a picture with him.
To Darnold, he's just throwing that shit back.
What sport has where their GOAT is literally number one or two in every stat and one in winning?
Tennis, maybe.
You look at the NBA, the GOAT fluctuates, and even then, there's not the most. They don't have the most chances.
I think football is the only sport.
Swimming, like Phelps.
Nah, not even in soccer either. Nope.
I think football is the only sport.
Pele.
No.
Most championships, most goals.
He's not the best player ever, though. No, he does not have the most goals. Messi has the most goals.
You're not going to stop.
No, Pele has like over 800 goals. I'm bugging?
No, like throughout his entire career.
That's what I'm saying.
But Messi has the most international goals.
For sure.
He just passed them.
For sure.
That's what I'm saying. Tom Brady has everything.
But and Messi has the most La Liga goals, too.
But Pele also has the World Cups. That's why they...
That's the knock on Messi. He doesn't have a World Cup.
But Tom, I think football is the only sport where there's an undisputed GOAT. Tom Brady's the undisputed GOAT. Yep. And anybody that tries to argue it, it's really no point of arguing it right now.
Surge.
He tries to argue
it? He will argue it down.
A lot of people try to argue Payton, but he's not.
I talked to this
guy. I'm a
Payton
fan. I will tell you, Payton's 3. It's Joe Montana, and then number one, Tom Brady.
Tough. You have him at three.
No, not Pitt.
I got it. I got
you know what's crazy?
Tom How about
Brady.
Regular season.
Regular season. Peyton
Manning's
undoubtedly.
Peyton Manning's the GOAT in the regular season.
Tom Brady is second all time in fourth quarter comebacks, and he's.
Who's one?
Historic Peyton Manning.
Yeah.
And he's historically played with teams that blow teams out. So that means that Tom Brady, when he gets his chances to do it,
done.
He it's does over. It. There's no doubt about it. He gets the job done.
That's insane.
And that's why he's so great. So how amazed are you by Tom Brady's greatness and how long he's been able to sustain it? How long can he play?
It's really that. I'm more amazed by how long he's been playing. Like, forget the numbers. He's playing at 40 years old.
And he's a great guy.
All right. Yeah. I mean, I don't
care.
That's
up for debate. He's become a great guy.
I think he's a great guy.
Who cares? Who cares?
No, but that plays a part.
Who cares?
That definitely plays a part.
Great guy or not, whether he's an asshole or not, he has 600 teams.
Barry Bonds is arguably the greatest baseball player ever.
He's known as a dickhead.
Exactly. People, they despise Barry Bonds.
He's still known as what?
Not really.
But the respect
really.
Isn't there.
He cheated, bro.
That, oh, allegedly. Well, then,
I
mean, never
I don't know,
test.
But I'm not
yeah,
going to
get
into
he allegedly cheated.
Why isn't he in the Baseball Hall of Fame?
Because
then?
They have the alleged thing that he
There's
did
horror
steroids.
Stories from people that covered the team, the media guys, that Barry Bonds used to just be
a
asshole.
Horrible human being.
I personally don't, like, me personally, I don't care if you're an asshole or not. It's what you do, like, what do you do on that court?
I mean, whenever I watch, whenever
I agree.
Whenever I watch Tom Brady play, and after he wins a game or, you know, they interview him post-game, whenever he talks in a really humble
That's
manner.
A fact.
And I watched games with my dad, and my dad said, man, he's a great guy, man. You could tell he's just a humble dude. And that's the thing. When I see Tom Brady, you can just tell he's a humble guy. You know,
like, you're the worst Jets fan.
The press conference, he, you know, when the guy had the 600 touchdown ball, he said that was really nice of him to give it back, and that was really cool of him. And that's why when it get like, what player's giving somebody a Bitcoin? Tom Brady's like, I'm gonna give you a Bitcoin. This I'm gonna secure your future with the Bitcoin.
Not for real.
Like, that's real, bro. That's real.
I mean,
you seem really excited about him as a man.
I just think Tom Brady's great,
bro,
man.
I mean, we're Jets fans, bro. We know firsthand how
you just
great
said you
this
hate
guy
him.
Is. I hate him, but like
I don't hate Tom
I
Brady.
Respect him. I hate him, but I respect him.
I love Tom Brady because I think when you're watching somebody that's doing something at such a high level, you have to respect it. You have to just honor the greatness.
Yeah.
Because Tom,
I think you can honor the greatness and still hate them.
That's what I do. He's great.
I just have huge admiration for Brady because you got to understand, for Brady to be doing it this long, to be this good for this long, he has mastered the quarterback position. He has mastered mechanics. He has mastered reading defenses. He has mastered adjusting his protection, reading things pre-snap. We're watching a master at his craft right now.
Yep.
And for him to be 44, 45, and he's in the MVP conversation.
Insane.
I mean, Brett Favre fizzled out. Payne fizzled out.
Drew Brees.
He
fizzled out. That's
he
fair.
Fizzled
he
out
fizzled
because
out.
He couldn't throw the
yes,
ball down the
correct.
Field.
Big Ben, same thing.
Yeah, everybody knocked Brady.
Cooked.
Brady's last year in New England. Everybody knocked him, said he couldn't throw the ball deep. He said, watch this. I'm going to go to Tampa Bay and Bruce Arians' offense, known for throwing the ball down the field, win a Super Bowl in my first season there. I mean, that's just historically great.
One thing that stands out to me, and then we can move on. His MVP season in 2010, he had 36 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. Last season, he had 40 touchdowns at age 43. 40 touchdowns. I think he had 12 interceptions, something along those lines. Threw for 800 more yards than his MVP season. The year difference from 2010 to 2021, for him to have those numbers still at the age of 43, that's what amazes me most. Obviously, we don't see people do this at age 36, 37. The fact he's doing it at 43, 44, it is unheard of in any sport, truthfully. You don't see, I mean, I think baseball is the only sport where you see people over the age of 40 have some kind of success. Never in football, never in basketball. I think Kareem Abdul-Jabbar was really the only one, and he had a visible drop-off. Brady's yet to show that.
Brady is a Hall of Famer in 3 decades, 2000s Hall of Famer, 2010s Hall of Famer, and even in the 2020s, he's won the first Super Bowl in 2020s, and 2021, the Bucks could win again. We don't know.
I mean, did you guys see the Tom Brady and Peyton Manning and Eli?
Yeah, I saw it.
It was amazing. Yeah. It really
Tom
was
Brady
great.
Was talking about how he called Peyton before he went to understand how you integrate the offense into the how he integrated the Colts offense into
Denver.
He called Peyton to see how he would do that same thing. So I thought that was pretty cool. I didn't
That's close. Another thing I like about Tom Brady too, and about just I think Peyton Manning as well, is that you see in a lot of other sports people that you had a lot of battles with, you were very competitive with, when they retire, they're not the best of friends. They're still that thing. Tom Brady, anybody he's faced, like, you can see that there's nothing but admiration. When they're on the football field, they're competitive as hell. But outside of it is nothing but love, is admiration for what you did for the game. And I think that's an amazing thing.
They played in a golf game.
Facts. Tom and Phil Mickelson and Tiger.
It's hilarious.
They played TB12.
I'm going to say Payne's had a lot of time to work.
Are you
going to
buy
strokes.
Some of those products by from TB12?
I personally will not be, because I cannot own anything Tom Brady related out of respect for my GOAT, Peyton Manning, but I can understand why people would buy it.
I don't even know what he's selling.
He's selling a lot of T-shirts, the hat,
oh,
Tampa
I'm cool
Bay.
Off that.
No. He's selling a bunch of things also to have your body youthful and, like, I guess just
the
workout
TB12
stuff.
Method.
Mm-hmm. Just workout stuff.
Who were they clowning yesterday? Oh, I'm blanking on his name so badly.
Eli?
No, it was a coach of theirs, and he was wearing the TB12 shirt, and he was like, oh, is this guy on the TB12 method? Oh, man, I wish you guys were watching.
I saw it, yeah.
You know, I don't know
his
name.
It was a coach.
Yeah,
just a coach.
Facts. But he definitely did not look like he was using the TB12 method by any means. So who knows how effective it truthfully is.